Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Medical Hub. Today I am going to share some multiple choice questions of infection control. These questions are very important in nursing exams, upcoming nursing exams. So now let's start. In this video, only 30 MCQs with answers. So now let's see. Question number first. Microbes that cause disease are? There are four options. A. Frequent hand washing. B. Pathogens. C. Clean utility room. And D. Carrier. Right answer is B. Pathogens. Pathogens that cause the disease. So microbes that cause the disease are pathogens. Next question. Question number 2. The nurse aide should wash their hands. Option A. Before and after caring for each patient. Client. B. Blood and body fluid transmission. C. Prevent the spread of infection. D. Routinely in the care of all clients. Right answer is A. Before and after caring for each client. So the nurse aide should wash their hands before and after caring for each patient or each client. Next question. Question number 3. You are assigned to collect a midstream urine specimen from a male client. You must. Option A. Are discarded in leak-proof cupboard containers. B. Wear personal protective equipment. C. Rinse and intense etching. D. Wash the perineum first to prevent specimen contamination. Right answer is D. Wash the perineum first to prevent specimen contamination. Next question. Question number 4. The best method of preventing the spread of infection is? Option A. Frequent hand washing. B. Pathogens. C. Rinse and intense etching. And D. Carrier. Right answer is A. Frequent hand washing. Frequent hand washing is the best method of preventing the spread of infection. Next question. Question number 5. You are instructed to collect a regular urine specimen from a female client. You should. Option A. Wash the perineum first to prevent specimen contamination. B. Keep clean and dirty items separate in the bedside stand. C. Apply gloves and place the dressing in the plastic bags. D. Apply the principles of standard precaution when obtaining the specimen. Right answer is D. Apply the principles of standard precaution when obtaining the specimen. So when you are instructed to collect a regular urine specimen from a female client, you should apply the principles of standard precaution when obtaining the specimen. Next question. Question number 6. When cleaning soiled client care items, the nurse aide should. Option A. Wear personal protective equipment. B. Rinse and intense etching. C. Touching an infected wound. D. Clean utility room. Right answer is A. Wear personal protective equipment. When cleaning soiled client care items, nurse aide should be wear personal protective equipment. Next question. Question number 7. Waste products that are contaminated with blood or body fluids. Option A. Prevent the spread of infection. B. Is isolated in contact precaution. C. Are discarded in leak-proof cupboard containers. D. Routinely in the care of all client. Right answer is C. Are discarded in leak-proof cupboard containers. So waste products that are contaminated with blood or body fluids should be discarded in leak-proof cupboard containers. Next question. Question number 8. A client who is newly diagnosed with head lice or scabies. Option A. Prevent the spread of infection. B. Touching an infected wound. C. Is isolated in contact precaution. D. Rinse and intense etching. Right answer is C. Is isolated in contact precaution. A client who is newly diagnosed with head lice or scabies is isolated in contact precautions. Next question. Question number 9. The nurse aide is responsible for cleaning client care supplies and equipment too. Option A. Routinely in the care of all client. B. बी फ्रिक्वेंट हैंड वॉशिंग, सी रेस एंड इंटेंस ईचिंग, डी प्रिवेंट द स्प्रेड ऑफ इन्फेक्शन. राइट आंसर इज डी प्रिवेंट द स्प्रेड ऑफ इन्फेक्शन. The nurse aide is responsible for cleaning client care supplies and equipments to prevent the spread of infection. Next question, question number 10. In addition to hand washing and wearing gloves, the use of standard precaution involve. Option A, understanding how pathogens are spread and using various equipment to protect yourself. B, prevent the spread of infection. C, wear personal protective equipment. D, apply gloves and place the dressing in a plastic bag. Right answer is A. Understanding how pathogens are spread and using various equipment to protect yourself. Next question, question number 11. Infectious disease such as hepatitis B or hepatitis C become a reservoir for pathogens in. Option A, blood. B, urinary tract. C, the reproductive tract. And D, the respiratory tract. Right answer is A, blood. Infectious disease such as hepatitis B or hepatitis C become a reservoir for pathogens in blood. Next question, question number 12. What to use to sterilize surgical instrument and surgical dressings? Option A, autoclaving. B, soap and water. C, ethylene oxide gas. D, chemicals are used for disinfection. Right answer is A, autoclaving. Autoclaving is used to sterilize surgical instrument and surgical dressing. Next question, question number 30. Hospital acquired UTI or urinary tract infection are often related to poor hand washing and. Option A, improper catheter care. B, poor perineal hygiene. C, urinary drainage bags. D, poor urinary output. Right answer is A, improper catheter care. Hospital acquired UTI are often related to poor hand washing and improper catheter care. Next question, question 14. Most important step in clinical area waste management is. Option A, labeling. B, storage. C, transportation. D, segregation. Right answer is D, segregation. Segregation is the most important step in clinical area of waste management. Next question, question 15. When a nurse is performing surgical hand asepsis, the nurse must keep hands. Option A, below elbow. B, above elbow. C, at a 45 degree angle. D, in a comfortable position. Right answer is B, above elbow. When a nurse is performing surgical hand asepsis, the nurse must keep hands above the elbow. Next question, question 16. Which of the following is the most prevalent risk factor in the development of catheter-associated UTI or urinary tract infection? Option A, catheter care violation. B, prolonged catheterization. D, C, increased aging. D, female gender. Right answer is B, prolonged catheterization. Prolonged catheterization is the most prevalent risk factor in the development of catheter associated UTI. Next question, question 17. During hospital waste management, waste human body parts are discarded in. Option A, red bag. B, yellow bag. C, black bag. And D, blue bag. Right answer is B, yellow bag. During hospital waste management, waste human body parts are discarded in yellow bag. Next question, question 18. Antibiotics solutions and sera are sterilized by. Option A, pasteurization. B, boiling. C, radiation. And D, hot air oven. Right answer is D, hot air oven. Hot air oven should be used for the sterilization of antibiotic solution and sera. Next question, question 19. For effective sterilization by autoclave, temperature should be. Option A, 90 degree Celsius for 10 minutes. B, 121 degree Celsius for 30 minutes. C, 150 degree Celsius for 30 minutes. D, 121 degree Celsius for 5 minutes. Right answer is B, 121 degree Celsius for 30 minutes. For effective sterilization by autoclaving temperature should be 125 degree Celsius for 30 minutes. Next question, question 20. Sterilization of operation theater is done by option A autoclave, B ethylene oxide, C ultraviolet radiation, D gamma radiation. Right answer is C ultraviolet radiation. Sterilization of operation theater is done by the ultraviolet radiation. Next question, question number 21. Culture media containing sugars can be sterilized by option A filtration, B tandilization, C radiation, and D hot air oven. Right answer is B tandilization. Next question, question number 22. Heart lung machine is sterilized by option A chlorine, B hot air oven, C ethylene oxide, and D phenol. Right answer is C ethylene oxide. Heart lung machine is sterilized by ethylene oxide. Next question, question number 23. Uses of ultraviolet lamps include option A killing of organism, B making vaccines, C prevention of airborne infection, D all of the above. Right answer is D all of the above. Next question, question number 24. The process by which an article surface or medium is made free from all living microorganisms, including spores, is called as option A sterilization, B antisepsis, C disinfection, and D decontamination. Right answer is sterilization. Sterilization is the process by which an article surface or medium is made free from all living microorganisms, including spores. Next question, question number 25. The chemical agents that inhibit bacterial growth is called as option A bacteriostatic, B sterilant, C germicide, and D disinfectant. Right answer is A bacteriostatic. The chemical agent that inhibit bacterial growth is called as bacteriostatic. Next question, question number 26. What is the correct order of the chain of infection? Option A susceptible patient, then route of exit, then organism, then reservoir or source, then mode of transmission, and then route of entry. B organism, reservoir, route of exit, mode of transmission, route of entry, and susceptible host. C reservoir or source, organism, susceptible patient, route of exit, mode of transmission, and route of entry. Right answer is B organism, then reservoir or source, and then route of exit, and then mode of transmission, and route of entry, and susceptible patient. So the correct order of the chain of infection is organism, then reservoir, then route of exit, then mode of transmission, then route of entry, and susceptible patient. Next question, question number 27. The first movement in the five movements for hand hygiene occurs when? Option A, after patient contact on leaving the point of care, B, before you put on personal protective equipment, C, as near to the patient as possible within the patient zone, D, before you start to gather the equipment that you need to take to the patient's bedside. Right answer is C, as near to the patient as possible within the patient zone. So the first movement in the five movements for hand hygiene occurs when? As near to the patient as possible within the patient zone. Next question, question number 28. Gloves and aprons, option A, are single use items and must be worn for one task. B, should not be changed regularly as this isn't cost effective or a good use of resources. C, can be worn outside of the patient isolation or side room. D, must be worn together as you can't do any task without wearing both. Right answer is A. Gloves and aprons are single use items and must be worn for one task or episode of care only. Next question, question number 29. Standard precautions are must be. Option A, only applicable if the patient has a blood-borne virus infection. B, to be used when caring for patient with MRSA. सी अप्लाइड टू ऑल पेशेंट ऑल ऑफ द टाइम, डी यूज्ड व्हेन डीलिंग विद स्पिलिंग्स ऑफ ब्लड और बॉडीली फ्लूइड्स. राइट आंसर इज सी अप्लाइड टू ऑल पेशेंट ऑल ऑफ द टाइम. स्टैंडर्ड प्रिकॉशंस मस्ट बी अप्लाइड टू ऑल पेशेंट ऑल ऑफ द टाइम. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 30, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड अ पोर्टल ऑफ एंट्री फॉर बैक्टीरिया. ऑप्शन ए आई, बी नोज, सी माउथ एंड डी इंटैक्ट स्किन. राइट आंसर इज डी इंटैक्ट स्किन. इंटैक्ट स्किन इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड अ पोर्टल ऑफ एंट्री फॉर बैक्टीरिया.